Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. Let us sign ourselves in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today's reflection is on the Gospel of Luke, chapter 20, verses 27 to 40, and specifically verse 38, where Jesus tells the Sadducees that God is not the God of the dead, but of the living, for to Him all are alive. The Gospel reading offers us a wonderful teaching of Jesus on the resurrection of the dead. Jesus is asked by some Sadducees who do not believe in the resurrection and therefore provoke Him with a hypocritical question. In the resurrection, whose wife would a woman be if she had seven successive husbands who were all brothers, who all died one after the other? Jesus does not fall into the trap and replies that in the life to come, the risen neither marry nor are given in marriage, for they cannot die anymore, because they are equal to angels and are sons of God, being sons of the resurrection. We read this in verses 35 to 36. This is how Jesus responds. Jesus invites his questioners and asks to consider that this age in which we now live is not the only age, but that there is another, no longer subject to death, which will fully manifest that we are children of God. It is of great comfort and hope to listen to the simple and clear word of Jesus about life beyond death. We need it very much, especially in our time. So rich in knowledge about the universe, but so lacking in wisdom about eternal life. Jesus's clear certainty about resurrection is based entirely on the fidelity of God, who is the God of life. In fact, behind the question of the Sadducees is hidden a more profound question. Not only whose wife she will be, the widow of the seven husbands, but to whom will her life belong? This is a doubt that touches mankind of every age and also us. After this earthly pilgrimage, what will become of our life? Will it belong to nothing? To death? Jesus responds that life belongs to God, who loves us and cares very deeply about us, to the point of linking His name to ours. He is the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. Now, He is not God of the dead, but of the living, for to Him all are alive. We read this in verses 37 to 38. Life exists where there is a bond, communion, brotherhood. And it is a life stronger than death, when it is built on true relationships and bonds of fidelity. On the contrary, there is no life where one has the presumption of belonging only to oneself and of living as an island. death prevails in these attitudes. It is selfishness if I live for myself. I am sowing death in my heart. May our Blessed Mother help us to live every day from the perspective of what we affirm in the final part of the Creed. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God bless you all.